Philippine Senate Minority Leader and Justice Panel Chair Coco Pimentel has been tapped to lead the upper chamber's inquiry into the Duterte drug war. The move to conduct the Senate investigation was initiated by Senator Ronald de la Rosa, the chief architect of the war on drugs. But Senate President Francis Escudero said it would be better if de la Rosa did not lead the Senate's probe to avoid questions of impartiality. Pimentel, for his part, is confident he will be able to get insightful answers from his colleagues who were implicated in the House Quad Committee's probe. He will also give his colleagues limited time to ask questions or address the accusations hurled against them.
Wala tong pilitan. The price that they pay when they do not address issues raised against them is political. Makikita ng taong bayan na hindi sinasagot yung issue na tinatapon laban sa kanila. So, kaya tayo nag-hearing ng ganito para may chance silang sagutin yung issues na rinay sa kanila sa House of Representatives. And then, kung ayaw nilang sagutin pa sa hearing namin, the price is political.
The Philippine government may send a team to Malaysia to probe how dismissed Town Mayor Alice Goh fled to the country. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya insists Goh and her companions left the Philippines by air. However, the ex-mayor has maintained they fled to Malaysia through sea travel. Goh left the country last July amid accusations of setting up illegal offshore gaming operators.
But we might have to really send a mission to Malaysia. If it would not be revealed online or by Zoom, by video, then we might send somebody there. All the possible flights that they may have taken towards Kuala Lumpur, because it does not appear in any manifest. So we have to know how this was done, because in many ways it is a national security concern.
Rimulya also weighing in on the statements made by Vice President Sara Duterte in her Friday press conference. Rimulya says the Justice Department is studying the legal consequences of the statements Duterte made about former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Duterte admitted Friday she has threatened to exhume the remains of Marcos Sr. and throw his body in the West Philippine Sea.
Very disturbing for a person of her rank. Second highest official of the land, the remarks are unbecoming. Desecrates the memory of a person, desecrates the peaceful state that he must be in, having already perished, and he disturbed the body. And there are many other moral principles that are being violated. And we're looking at the legal aspects also. We're conducting a study.
The House of Representatives vowing no let-up in its probe into the alleged fund misuse of the office of the Vice President, despite threats from Sara Duterte. Our correspondent Vivian Gulia now on the line with that story. Viv?
Hi. Well, there should be no let-up in a House panel investigation into the alleged misuse of confidential funds in the office of Vice President Sara Duterte and in the Department of Education during Duterte's stint as its chief. That's according to House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability Vice Chairperson and Antipolo City 2nd District Representative Romeo Acop. He issued this statement after Duterte threatened to dig up the remains of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s father, late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., and to dump it into the sea if the supposed political attacks against her do not stop. House leaders have repeatedly denied that its investigation into the utilization of public funds of the OVP and the DepEd was politically motivated. Acop said giving leeway to the vice president would not be in accordance with the duty of the House of Representatives. Acop noted that Duterte appeared to have exposed a flaw in her character in last Friday's press conference. Some congressmen also urged the vice president to see a psychologist or a psychiatrist after what they perceive as a meltdown in her last press conference, where she also admitted imagining cutting off Marcos Jr.'s head. House Senior Deputy Speaker and Pampanga 3rd District Representative Aurelio Don Gonzalez Jr. also criticized Duterte's desecration threat against Marcos Sr., calling it foul. House Committee on Public Accounts Chairperson and Abang Lingkod Party List Representative Joseph Stephen Paduano, meanwhile, issued an unsolicited advice to the VP. And that is to give due courtesy to the office of the president, noting that she was given much courtesy during the House hearings. That's the latest. Back to you, Ron.
Thank you very much, Vivian Gulia.